on, come on. Can somebody hear what I'm saying? God didn't wait for your daddy to make you a priority before he made you a priority. God didn't wait on your mama before he made. He said before your mama knew you were in her womb, I called you. You are a priority before your mama even knew you were in the womb. I didn't wait for some doctor to tell her she was pregnant before I made you. Your problem is you don't know that you're a priority. Here's what I want you to ask yourself. When are you going to finally level up? No, come on, write that down. When are you going to level up? When are you going to level up? Jeremy, you said it was a version of the car that was a junk car, and there was a version of a car that was a classic. When are you going to level up? You got classic on in you, and the owner is ready to classic you out. The reason why you haven't been classic out, because you keep telling the owner, no, I'm waiting for somebody else to make me a priority. He's like, oh, okay, let me know. Let me know when you ain't looking for a man to make you a priority no more, and you want to make the Alpha and Omega make you a priority. Let me know when you're ready for me to, when you gonna level up? Huh? God told me to say to you today, when you gonna level up? Listen to me. I told you, you're not an animal, you're not the trees, you're not insects. You was made on the sixth day. Even in creation, you was a priority. Ain't nobody, all the other ones, he just said, let there be, and let there be, and let there be, and let there be. When he made you, he said, come on, y'all. Let us. I didn't hear no us with whales. I just heard, let there be, and it was. I didn't hear no us with eagles. It's just let there be. And eagles are bad, and whales are bad. But when he made us, he said, come on, everybody. It's going to take all three of us to do this one. Oh, you just missed what I said. That's your freedom from being raped. That was your freedom to set, because you still own he took from me. That was your freedom right there. That he knew everything that was going to happen. And even though you looking at it bad, he knew it was going to be. You still on what happened to you. It's not, it's over. I made this mistake. No, let us make. Your problem is you every day you sitting there talking about who you are based on your mistake. And you not talking about you based on the three coming together and creating you. That's where your focus needs to be. That you let us make man in our image after our likeness. You are a priority. I know you want your mama's favorite, but you are God's priority. I know you want your daddy's favorite. Come on, how many of you, just be honest, raise your hand. I grew up in a house. My biological father didn't even grow up in the house with me, or we ain't had that kind of relationship. Let me just see your hand, be honest. Just put your hands up. I just wasn't even in the same house as my, yeah. Yeah, come on, keep your hands up. How many of y'all, me and my father, we don't even have that kind of relationship. Let me just see that. And you know why? God didn't take a chance on your priority to a human. Oh, come on. Can somebody hear what I'm saying? God didn't wait for your daddy to make you a priority before he made you a priority. God didn't wait on your mama before he made. He said before your mama knew you were in her womb, I called you. You are a priority before your mama even knew you were in the womb. I didn't wait for some doctor to tell her she was pregnant before I made you. Your problem is you don't know that you're a priority. And you walk, Joseph, you walk different when you know. Rachel, I could just imagine in those 7 years, Rachel was walking around like, this Negro working for me. Look at all that work he doing. And my dad putting that boy to work. He got a motivation. Better get on your grind. Oh, my. I could just imagine how she was just walking around like, yep. Let me get ready. This boy loved me. He in the fifth year. He ain't quit yet. My. Hey, man, God's not waiting for a human to do it. He did it already. That's why he made you last. That's why he gave you the gifts he gave you. And you're too busy taking your gifts and asking what other humans think about the gifts that God has given you. You're so worried about how your gifts. Good. Psalms 139:14. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous. Keep it right there. Keep it right there. Don't stop. Don't stop. Let them look at that. Get that in your spirit. Amen. You're not an accident. Amen. Yes, you might have messed up. And yes, they may or may not forgive you. And yes, they might fire you. And yes, they may not ever bring you back. And yes, they might treat you some type of way because they not. Whatever. Go back to Psalms 139:14. Bump what they say about you. What does God say? God says, for I fearfully and wonderfully made you. Marvelous are my works. Let my soul know of right well. You better stop worrying about what man think about what God has done. We all made mistakes. We all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We all have done stuff with it. That's not who you are. You are wonderful. I'm sorry. You are fearful. God made you fearfully. God? What is he afraid of? God? What is he meticulous about? God? Why does he need to worry about structure and order? God, I don't make no mistakes. But yet, because he loves you so much, even when he made you, he was fearful. I got, man, I can't mess up.
Oh, that's good.
I got to get this right. This is my greatest creation of yet. This is the last one right here. Shh. Let's fear fearfully. Either the word is right or it's lying. Fearful. When you do something fearfully, there's a level of honor and respect. There's a value you place on something when you do it fear. When I was a kid and we played marbles, them crazy looking marbles, we just throw them jokers. But those marbles, that them crystal boys, them ones that cost $2 and you had to rake leaves for those jokers. Oh, when we did those, it was the left eye was closed. Oh, it was on some fearful boy, because if your boy get that, he can keep that. I had the three fingers. Oh, come on, y'all. The crazy looking marbles, we was just pop, pop, pop. But when you did that $4, $5 boys, everybody would come around the playground. Ooh. E.T. going up against Mike for the, ooh. Everybody, girls was around, the fellas was around. You got street cred if you got, you could do that. I probably shouldn't be saying this in church, but I kept my marbles in that purple bag. Fear, you weren't rushed. You weren't rushed. You weren't an afterthought. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. Hug yourself right now. Say it. I'm fearful, fearfully, and wonderfully made. Hug yourself. Hug yourself. Come on. Hug yourself and say it. Come on. Especially those of you who waiting on somebody else to tell you you're valuable before you think you're valuable. Somebody else to invite you somewhere, do something. Some of us have. I walked around so long with low self-esteem, you know, worrying about what other people thought. I wanted them to affirm me and value me, and I'd be doing some dumb stuff so I could get their value. Just hug yourself and say, I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. I'm God's priority. Come on, I'm God's priority. Come on, I'm God's priority. And the best is yet to come. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. Neither has it entered into the heart of man, God's idea for me. I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. This is the year to level up, y'all. Level up in your relationships. Level up in our health. Level up in our emotional and mental space. Level up financially. Level up in our business. This is the year to level up, y'all. Why? Because we already wired to do it. No, I need you to hear what I'm saying. We're about to get out of here. I need you to understand before you leave today, no matter what has happened to you, no matter what somebody said to you, no matter what somebody did to you, I need you to walk away knowing you are one of one. Here's why I need you to know you are one of one. Because if you're going to make a God of the priority and you're going to go forward from this day forward, the only way you're going to turn heads and get God's attention from his people for him is that you're gonna have to strive. Let's go back. Let's go over it again. Rolls Royce, I want to go over it again. Right. Put this in your phone. Here's what God wants you to do. Strive for perfection. Don't mean you got to be perfect, but strive for it. People tell me all the time, oh, you got this thing, this image. You trying to be 1,000%. I'm trying to be perfect. 1,000%. It don't mean, I'm not trying to dog you out. I'm not judging you. I don't even think I'm better than you, but I am striving for perfection. I am. I'm definitely not trying to be the same version of Eric Thomas I was last year or the month before. I'm definitely, if you knew me 5 years ago, you better take a picture. Because the only way you're going to be able to prove that person existed is that you got film on it. I will not be the same individual after 30 days. I'm going to keep growing. Number one, listen to me. As you realize you are a priority, here's what I want you to do moving forward. I want you to strive for perfection. Now listen to me, when we leave today, whatever Yahweh is said about us, I want us to do it. So we'll start here. Let's go again. We'll start here. Whatever God is saying to you, I want you to do it. Number one, strive for perfection in everything. That sound like God? No. Y'all not hearing what I'm saying. When you leave today, leader, and I'm giving my age, I could say Ford Fusion, but I'm saying escort. Can you stop being a Ford escort? We know you're capable of being one. Can you stop being a Cutlass Sierra? I know I'm telling my age, Erica. Cutlass Sierra, can you stop being a Cutlass Sierra? Can you stop being a Suburban? And can you leave here and between you and God, whatever the highest level he has for you, can you start reaching for that?
What up, what up, what up? It's your boy, E.T. Flight Assessment 2.0. Look, I love the assessment so much that it took me to a whole other level. Like, I'm telling y'all, y'all think I've always been here. I promise you, there was a time I was lost. I'm just being real. There was a time that I was just shooting. I didn't know what to aim for. Like, I didn't know. And so I wasn't making the money I'm making now. I didn't know, y'all. I had a gift, but I didn't really know what the gift was. I didn't know how to use it. I remember struggles in my marriage because I didn't know who I was, struggling with my kids. So the flight assessment was phenomenal because it changed my life. It gave me a sense of clarity that I never had before. Like, it showed me my value, and it showed me, like, how to market my value, how to understand my value, how to sell my value, like how to put a price tag on what I was worth. I didn't know before. I was watching other videos, watching other people, mimicking other people, trying to do what other people were doing. It didn't work, y'all. And then boom, this assessment showed me me. Now I'm gonna be honest. While I love the assessment, it was on some PhD stuff. Like, it was like an advanced degree. So I took the Flight Assessment 2.0 and simplified it for you. Flight Assessment now is a pilot, a flight attendant, a ground crew, air traffic control. Like, I simplified it with symbols and words that you can understand so that you can immediately take it and boom, and do something with it. You're going to be able to use it immediately. You're gonna figure out who you are, why you tick, what you do, and then you're gonna be able to, boom, take who you are and what you do and put it in the marketplace and make money. Listen to me very closely. Not only are you gonna figure out who you are, you're gonna figure out who everybody around you is, and guess what? You're gonna slow life down. You're gonna slow the game down, and you're gonna be able to do and be and have stuff you've never had before. So do me a favor, listen to me. In 15 minutes, your whole life is gonna change. Like, I revamped the whole thing. I made the investment. I studied this thing for 5-6 years. I studied you. I got it, y'all. I got it. It's gonna take 15 minutes. And in 15 minutes, you gonna know you like you've never known you before. You gonna have resources. You gonna have the people that's gonna be able to help you. You gonna be able to go, be, do, have everything you've ever dreamed of. You gonna speak with clarity. You gonna move with clarity. You gonna think with clarity. You gonna write with clarity. And that clarity is gonna open up doors that you never imagined that could be open. Are you hearing me? So I went from a YouTube sensation to the number one motivational speaker in the world. So I want you to do me a favor. Act right now. Don't think, don't overthink, right? Make the investment. Don't spend no money, make the investment. You're gonna get your money back. Click the button, register, sign up, and do me a favor. Bro, I promise you, when you do, after that 15 minutes, you are about to make the rest of your life the best of your life. It's your boy ET. The flight assessment has revolutionized my life and my family's life and my family's coming life. Let it revolutionize you and your family to come.